Welcome to the UNC Player Show on Fan Media Network. I'd like to welcome in George Lynch, 1993 national champion and longtime NBA player. I'm Matt Doherty, 1982 national champion and former head coach of the Tar Heels. George, we're coming off of a victory over Wake Forest, 80-73. Which we watched on Twitter Live with about 50 fans, and we're going to probably do that at least one more time. And I'll be ready with the technical update to get you included in that. But that was a lot of fun, and we'll do that again to have the fans join in. We could get to interact in real time. What were your thoughts on the key to the game?
Well, I think we stayed persistent with the throwing the ball inside. You know, I was a little worried there towards the end of the game when we were trading twos for threes, but Baycott came through with an and one, made the free throws, which were big, and Wake made some costly turnovers down the stretch. They gave us the lead.
Yeah. I thought a couple things. To me, the key was the foul line. And you've talked about this on many of our shows, that you want to make more foul shots than the opponents take. We did that. We made 19 out of 27. And they only took 17, but they did make 14. And the other thing is we forced 20 turnovers that led to 24 points. And we were 18 assists to 12 turnovers, which is probably one of the best, if not the best, assist to turnover ratio for our team this season. Any thoughts on those stats?
Yeah, normally, you know, this time of the year towards the, you know, the end of January, guys start to settle in and the guards start to understand the system a little bit more and what coach is asking for. Got better guard play, you know, the other night. So I think that gave us a chance. And, you know, anytime we get in high percentage shots at the rim, I think that helps.
I thought that combined between Davis and Love, it was their best game together, even though they both didn't start. Love started, Davis came off the bench. I just thought that the two of them had their best game to date, and it wasn't just the scoring. Love was 4-7 from the three-point line. He had three assists, still had three turnovers, two blocks, two steals. But I thought that there was a couple of decisions that each player made. Love, one time, came down in secondary in the first half, didn't really have anything and dribbled off to the wing and then let them flow into secondary break. I thought that was key. I never saw him do that before. Normally he likes to put his head down and try to get to the rim. And then Davis, in transition in the second half, pulled up inside the free throw line for a little bit of a push shot, jump shot, where normally he too, like most freshmen, like to put the head down and try to get to the rim and do a Euro step and force something that is not a high percentage play. So to your point, I think that those film sessions that they're probably having with Hubert and Steve Robinson and Brad Frederick and Coach Williams are starting to pay off.
Yeah, it takes a while for younger guys to come into their own. And you know, us being Carolina fans, we're a little impatient. Don't really have time for freshmen to make mistakes and cost us games. But, you know, I think the light is at the end of the tunnel. Mm-hmm. And hopefully, you know, the film development, you know, I see Love going to stand after games, getting extra shots. It's starting to all pay off.
Yeah, no, you're hopefully you're exactly right. All right. NC State Saturday, which we're filming this on Friday. They beat Carolina on December 22nd, which made for a bad Christmas. Since then, and I've never said this in basketball before, they've been 1-3-2. And people are like, well, two? I'm like, yeah, They won one, they lost three, and two postponements due to COVID. So their last game, they lost at Florida State by a score of 105-73. This will be their first game in 10 days. What are your expectations?
Hopefully they have a little rust. It's hard to duplicate game situations in 10 days. That's a long time for basketball. Coming to Chapel Hill, unfortunately, there's not a lot of fans. But we do have shooters rims. The kids from Wake Forest shot the lights out. Duke coming out into our gym and shooting the lights out all the time. So if we can do a better job of guarding the three-point line and consistently pound the ball inside this time, I'm not for sure if State has Thunderbird and those guys playing.
They do. I believe, played in the last game. And Thunderbird is number one in the conference in ACC play in field goal percentage. Manny Bates is number two. They're both at 65% from the field. So, the big problem in my eyes is the turnovers, because they force, they're number one in steals and number one in turnovers forced in the ACC. They force almost 18 turnovers a game, and that's been our problem. So it's going to be that battle, and the free throw line, to me, is key, as you've touched on. Do you make more foul shots than the opponent takes? And I think if we can take care of the ball, and get to the free throw line by pounding inside, getting their bigs in foul trouble, we should win the game. But taking care of the ball is the
That's a big ask.
Yeah. What is, I think in the last time we did a story, either before or after our NC State game, we shared some memories. Any memories of playing NC State at home that you'd care to share?
My first 2 years, NC State had good teams. They had Tom Lugada, Fire and Ice, Chris Corciani, and came in and gave us the business. It was probably one of their better games between Corciani and what was the other guard's name?
Rodney Monroe.
They might have combined for 60.
Really? Did you win?
No, we didn't. First 2 years, I think we lost to State at our place. They had Tom Gugliotta, which we became good friends when I was down in Atlanta. He's a great guy.
He's a Long Island guy. Of course he's a great guy.
Yeah. We were on the USA team together with Hubert Davis. And Tom is a good guy. There was some good battles with State those first 2 years. And then after that, I think we had our way with him.
Was Les Robinson the coach then, or Jim Valvano?
Valvano was the first. He was there all 4 years, I think. My all 4 years.
Valvano was?
Yes.
Gotcha. Yeah. He was a character. Valvano also from Long Island. And I wasn't in this game, but you may remember the last game in the Carmichael was against NC State. Carolina won. Valvano, after the game, I think shook hands with coach and went and got the game ball and went up and made the layup because he wanted to make the last basket in Carmichael. A true character.
Yeah.
So, all right. Well, I appreciate you coming on. Enjoy doing this show with you. Again, this is the UNC Players Show on Fan Media Network.
To host a player show or appear as a player on a player show, simply create a profile on Fan Media's iOS app or website. Select your teams and make a short intro video on your phone. Show hosts, reporters, former players, and superfans can use our Get Verified feature and make an intro video as well. And our mobile newsroom staff will reach out.